morning, children. Let's begin with the second topic of our lesson number one, Story of Village Palampur. The heading goes like Organization of Production. Now, before going into these three technical words, first of all, let us see what is the meaning of production. Production means to produce something. Now, what does this something means? Anything whichever the society demands, whichever the society is in need of, when the manufacturer are going to produce it, we will say it as production. Obviously, sochne wali baat hai children, agar aapko Reebok ke shoes chahiye, branded shirts chahiye, to aap kya karenge? There will be a demand. You will be going to the shops, you will be asking the shopkeepers again and again that we need these branded shirts. So they will be giving the requirement to the industries ki hame iska requirement hai. Industries are going to produce it. So ultimately ho kya raha hai? Production kya cheez hai? Production means an activity which the manufacturers are going to do. It depends upon the requirement of the people living in that country. So, a question, one mark ka aisa bhi banta hai children, that what is the aim of production? Kya zarurat hai production karne ki? Zarurat hi nahi hai koi cheez produce karne ki. Aur agar hum kar rahe hai, then why? What is the need? So, the aim of production is to produce such goods and services that we want. We means the society. Hame jo bhi cheez chahiye society mein, when we demands for it, the producers produces it. Hence, that is the ultimate aim of the production. Now, let us go back to the topic, organization of production. Organization of production means what? For producing something, there must be certain way of producing it. So, what are those ways? This organization of production is also called as, children, factors of production. It's a very important term, children, because from the entire lesson, this is one of the major question which is framed. Question kaise banta hai? What are the various factors of production? Yeah, what are the various organizations of production? It means ki production karne ke liye, what are the various ways, what are the various steps which we require? So, children, basically there are four factors of production under the heading of land, labor, physical capital and human capital. Now, let us understand these four technical terms. Abhi thoda sa typical lagega. Let us discuss it with one example, children. See, if you need to produce anything, kuch bhi cheez produce karni ho, bhale it is related to agricultural activity or it is related to manufacturing activity, you need, the first thing will be the land. Aapko land to chahiye hoga. Kuch bhi cheez produce karna hai. Let us take one example that we want to start a new school. Hame ek school ka construction karna hai. So what will be the first thing which you will be in need of? You will be in need of land first. Koi zameen to chahiye on which you are going to construct your building. Then you will be in need of labor. Kuch labors chahiye honge jo hamari building mein kaam kare, hamare construction site pe kaam kare. Then we need physical capital. A physical capital kya hoti hai? I will be explaining it to you one by one. Then we need human capital also. Through this example only. But let us go back. Abhi maine aapko bataya ki land chahiye hoga construction ke liye. To land akela hi nahi. Along with land, you need natural resources also. Like you may be in need of water. Somewhere you will be in need of some natural resources, trees and all, for the decoration purpose or for the decorum of your school. So the first factor which we have seen through our example is land. Ki hame land to chahiye hi hoga agar we need to construct a school. ठीक है अब लैंड के संग व्हाट एल्स वी विल बी इन नीड ऑफ लाइक सपोज इमेजिन ऑफ आवर स्कूल ओनली हमें लैंड के संग नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज भी चाहिए जैसे हमारा क्रिकेट ग्राउंड यू रिमेम्बर इट इज कंप्लीटली ग्रीन तो ग्रीन क्यों है वी हैव planted plants there. So, along with land, some natural resources are also required. We need water also to make it green. So, along with land, there will be some other natural resources also which you will be in need. In any production process, you will be in need of land. Now, land part is over. Let us go to the second one. Labor, I said. We will be in need of labor also. Ab construction ho raha hai school ka. So, there will be some workers who will be working. Now, children, labor can be classified under four headings. Skilled labor, unskilled labor, educated labor, uneducated labor. Skilled labor means some technical ones. Ab jaise tum school ki agar we will take the same example, so what we will see that there will be some skilled, kuch trainees wale honge, the one who will be helping. Some unskilled, unskilled means a construction karna hai, to there you don't need any technical training. Unko brick uthani hai, they will be mixing the cement, they will be placing it on one upon another, and the complete wall will be constructed. So unskilled there. Educated how? You need the teachers to teach you. Fine. Uneducated again, the fourth grade workers who will be helping in sweeping, cleaning, grooming. Skilled means some technical person who will be framing the question papers, making the changes, printing some circulars. So yes, sub-skilled, unskilled, educated, uneducated, all types of labors will be required in the activity of production. So the first one was land factor, the second factor was labor, then comes physical capital. Physical capital means variety of input which required at every stage during the production. Now what does this word input means? You people are computer students, right? Input means what? Whenever we type something and it get enter, that is input. Okay, so in production process also we need various inputs. कोई भी चीज हमने प्रोड्यूस कर दी, हमारे पास लेबर आ गया, अब हमको चीजें अंदर डालने के लिए भी चाहिए. Now what are the things which we need as an input? Like for example, I said for school. अब स्कूल के लिए क्या इनपुट है? फिजिकल कैपिटल है. फिजिकल कैपिटल दो तरीके की उन्होंने बताई है, फिक्स कैपिटल एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल. अब स्कूल के लिए फिक्स कैपिटल मीन्स इफ यू हैव परचेज्ड लाइक बेंचेस, देन योर स्मार्ट क्लास, स्मार्ट क्लास बोर्ड्स, देन द रूम्स विच हैव बीन कंस्ट्रक्टेड, ऑल दीज विल फॉल अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ फिक्स कैपिटल. व्हाई चिल्ड्रन? Because fixed capital means the capital which you have invested and now you do not have to spend money on it in the coming years. Ek bar khareed liya to bar bar uske upar paisa lagane ki zarurat nahi hai. So benches ek bar aa gayi, toot phoot ho gayi, repairing will be required. But once you have purchased, suppose 10,000 benches for your school, every year you need not to purchase it again and again. So that will be called as your fixed capital. Ek bar building school ki ban gayi, to usko you will be need to increase the number of rooms. But the rooms which have already been constructed, har saal to usko tod kar nahi banayenge. To fixed capital means what? That once you have invested in something, once you have made something and you know there is no need to invest in the same thing again and again every year, then it will be called as your fixed capital. I have written here example, tools, buildings, machines, etc. Fine. Now the second category of physical capital is working capital. Working name itself is suggesting, means something which we need in a continuous process, in a working process. So working capital means raw material and money in hand. Two things come in working capital. Now raw material means, like if I will take the same example which I have given you for a school. Ab isme raw material kya hai hamara? Raw material is chalk, ink of marker, markers, means those things which we will need regularly, on regular basis. Bar bar chahiye hogi hame, har mahine chahiye hogi. So that will be called as my raw material. I will be in need of it again and again. It will come under working capital. And money in hand, obviously cash to hame chahiye, koi bhi cheez khareedni, electricity ka bill bharna hai agar school ka, then we need cash. We need cash for repairing, we need cash for purchasing markers, we need cash for purchasing the ink, for making the payment to variety of labors. So for everything we will be in need of cash. Hence what we have seen, children, what does this physical capital means? Physical capital means the various input which we require for the production process. Physical capital is classified under two headings. One is fixed capital, one is working capital. Fixed capital means the capital in which you do not have to invest again and again. Once you have invested in it, it will go in long run. Working capital means cash and raw material will be called as your working capital because it is required again and again in the production process. Hope, children, these three terms are clear to you. Now comes to the last factor of production, that is called as human capital. Children, for this we will not go much into the depth because our lesson number 2 is completely based on it, where we will be studying this particular heading in detail. For time being, you just try to understand human capital means the knowledge and the enterprise required by the human beings. कोई भी काम करने के लिए हमें जो नॉलेज चाहिए एंड द बिजनेसमैन व्हिच वी रिक्वायर्ड टू वर्क अलोंग विद ऑल दीज थ्री फैक्टर्स विल बी कमिंग अंडर ह्यूमन कैपिटल. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस क्विकली मूव बैक टू द टॉपिक ऑफ आवर बुक. गो बैक टू द सेम पालमपुर विलेज. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज फार्मिंग इन पालमपुर. चिल्ड्रन, एज इट इज अ विलेज सो ऑटोमेटिकली फार्मिंग एक्टिविटी विल बी द डोमिनेंट वन. और पालमपुर क्या, इफ आई विल आस्क यू लाइक वॉट इज द मेजर एक्टिविटी ऑफ द विलेजेस इन इंडिया, सो फार्मिंग विल बी द मेन एक्टिविटी, क्योंकि कोई भी विलेज में द मेजर एक्टिविटी विल बी फार्मिंग. फाइन, सो लेट अस सी कि पालमपुर में वॉट इज द सीन ऑफ फार्मिंग एक्टिविटी. सी चिल्ड्रन, द मेजर लिमिटेशन ऑफ फार्मिंग इज दैट द लैंड इज लिमिटेड. We know we treat land as a resource. Resource means something which is very important for us. But land is limited. You all agree with me? Land is limited, right? You cannot increase the area of the land because whatever land is available. Now, if I will come back to the lesson, in Palampur village, whatever area of land they were having, they have utilized complete area. Somewhere they have their farms, somewhere wells are there. Some areas roads are being constructed, somewhere they have schools, then they have like private dispensary and all. So means complete area, complete land is totally utilized in Palampur village. Now the question arises, children, that if the complete land is being utilized, then what can be done to increase the land area? Why do we need to increase? ऐसा क्वेश्चन आता है कि मैम इंक्रीज करना ही क्यों है. सी चिल्ड्रन, इन पालमपुर, नॉट ओनली इन पालमपुर, इन एवरी विलेज देर इज सम स्ट्रेटेजी ऑफ फार्मिंग. किसी तरीके से फार्मिंग का कोई पैटर्न होता है. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ड्यूरिंग रेनी सीजन खरीफ क्रॉप्स आर ग्रोन. खरीफ क्रॉप मीन्स ज्वार, बाजरा, जहां पर पानी चाहिए. नाउ In Palampur village, what they do during rainy season, they grow kharif crop, and this kharif crop is used as a cattle feed. Cattle feed means janwaron ko khilane ke liye they use it. Fine. Then during winter season, what they do, they grow rabi crop. Rabi crop means wheat, this type of crop. This is an example of rabi crop. Then sometimes they grow the third crop also on their fields, which is potato. Comes that which is the third crop which the farmers of Palampur grow. So remember it, potato is the third crop. Some of the farmers also grow sugar cane on their fields, and it is harvested once in a year. Then they make jaggery from it and they sell it in the nearby town and villages. Jaggery means what, children? Jaggery means gud. Sugar cane se they make gud also. So what is the complete use of telling all these things, kharif, rabi, potato, sugar cane? I am trying to make you clear that Palampur farmers have this type of cultivating pattern, that they grow kharif crop, they grow rabi, they use potato as the third crop. Somewhere if on the field some space is left, then they cultivate sugar cane also. Lekin ye sugar cane ka harvesting is only done once in a year. To pure saal bhar ke liye they put sugar cane. Then they make jaggery of it, then they sells it. This is the complete pattern of the farming in Palampur. Now again the same question from which I have started, that if I need to increase the land, the production, I know that I cannot increase the land area. Lekin mujhe production increase karna hai because population of Palampur is increasing. Population to har saal increase hogi. So what is the way to provide food stuff to the increasing population when I know that land area I cannot increase? There should be definitely a way. Children, there are three ways through which you can increase the crop production. One is multiple cropping. Multiple cropping means what? Growing more than one crop on the same piece of land in a year. एक ही साल में आप जब अलग अलग क्रॉप्स ग्रो करते हैं then we called it as multiple cropping, multiply करना. अब how does it work? For example, this is a plot area. During rabi season, farmer of Palampur has grown wheat. Now, wheat का harvesting is over. अब now still months are left in a year. तो wheat के harvest होने के बाद free time में what they have done? They have grown muskmelon on the same field. Then once harvesting of muskmelon is over, then they have grown kharif. In kharif season they have cultivated rice. So on the same piece of land during 1 year only, during few months or during rabi season wheat is grown, during free time muskmelon is cultivated, then again during kharif season rice is being cultivated. So ek hi land par in different months farmers have grown different crops. This is called as multiple. They have grown multiple crops on the same field during a year. This will be called as multiple cropping. Now let us see the second way through which we can increase the production. Second is mixed cropping. Mixed cropping means to grow more than one crop on a piece of land during the same time period. Now see children, little difference is there. Same time period means what? There is one plot only. It can be divided into two or four parts. One part they will grow jowar, one side they will grow bajra. Means on the same field when the farmers are growing different types of crops in particular month only, then it is called as mixed cropping. Mixed cropping mein kya hota hai? एक ही फील्ड पे एक ही फील्ड को डिवाइड कर देते हैं और उस पे उस पर्टिकुलर मंथ में कौन कौन सी लाइक क्रॉप्स कैन बी ग्रोन इज कल्टिवेटेड टुगेदर. So that is called as mixed cropping. Now comes the third pattern, very important, which is called as modern farming. Modern means something which is high tech. Modern farming, similarly how you will define it, that modern farming means the method through which you can increase the yield. Yield means the output of the produce. अब कैसे आउटपुट इंक्रीज करेंगे? इफ आई एम यूजिंग न्यू मेथड्स ऑफ फार्मिंग. न्यू मेथड्स ऑफ फार्मिंग मीन्स यूजिंग HYV सीड्स, मॉडर्न मशीनरीज, एग्जाम्पल ट्रैक्टर्स, हार्वेस्टर्स, स्प्रिंकलर्स एक्सेट्रा, ऑल आर कॉल्ड एज द मॉडर्न मेथड. सो व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू यूज मॉडर्न टेक्निक फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग द प्रोडक्शन, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज मॉडर्न फार्मिंग. Now HYV seeds means what children? HYV stands for high yielding variety of seeds. Now this is generic seeds which are like having potentiality to grow more seeds than required. If normal seeds se cultivation karoge, suppose 10 kg of wheat you are able to produce, but if you will use HYV seeds, when the output will come it would vary from 60 to 80 kg. तो बहुत vast difference हो जाता है when you use modern farming method for production activity. Children, this HYV seed has brought green revolution in our country. Green revolution in our country means everywhere there was good production of wheat and rice. Where but it was in especially in some of the states, Punjab, Haryana and western Uttar Pradesh, and it took place in late 1960s. In the year, if I am going to ask which was the year when green revolution started, it was 1960s. Now what does green revolution means? Green revolution means to produce wheat and rice by using HYV seeds, or you can even say that by using modern farming of farming methods. एक और क्वेश्चन आता है 1 mark का फ्रॉम द सेम टॉपिक, विच वर द स्टेट्स हु वर फर्स्ट टू यूज मॉडर्न फार्मिंग मेथड. सो अगेन यू हैव टू राइट पंजाब, हरियाणा एंड वेस्टर्न उत्तर प्रदेश. दीज स्टेट्स वर द फर्स्ट वन टू प्रोड्यूस और टू बी द पार्ट ऑफ ग्रीन रिवॉल्यूशन. Children, that's all for today. The remaining portion of the chapter we will see in our next video. Till that time, watch the video and do the needful which has been told to you. Have a nice day.